Good morning, YouTube. It's I got a little bit of an early start. It's 6:25 right now. On my way to work, it is raining. It's supposed to rain all day and heavy this afternoon. This has been a really strange summer here. It's rained at some point in the day, almost every day, all summer. And yesterday and today, there was flooding. There's more flooding expected. It's just pretty crazy. I don't know what's up, but when I grew up, there wasn't much rain in the summertime. Of course, I didn't grow up here in Colorado, but even for here, I think it's a little odd. Too much rain, and the rain causes Christina to feel pain and to be uncomfortable. So, I don't know. It's just weird. And I don't mind the rain so much, but it is summertime, so I'm, expecting sun and warmth. And anyways, that's the least of my troubles. So Chris went with me to my doctor's appointment yesterday. I had to redo a blood test. He actually ordered more blood tests, so I'm going to have to go back to the lab at some point. Gave me a prescription. We're kind of waiting to see where I'm at with pre-diabetes or what have you. I think they want to do a sleep study to see if I have sleep apnea. So I guess I got to take a class and take a machine home for that. Not too fun, but maybe some of these things will help with my general energy level. He is happy with my lipid panel, my cholesterol counts, and said I'm at a low risk for heart attack or stroke. But we'll see. I guess depending on what the A1C test, the glucose, reveals, that might increase my risk if I am, diabetic. So, in which case, he mentioned statin drugs, but I haven't heard good things about those. I guess I have some research to do. Hey there. So, still on my way to work. It's still raining, and it will be all day. So, tomorrow is the second round of vaccinations for Christina in this clinical trial. We are still really hopeful that it's going to help her. She still feels pain and liver pressure pain from the tumors, but I believe her doctor said that she could start feeling some relief after a week or two. And she did mention she thinks it's a little less painful. So, maybe it's working. It's probably too soon to tell, but we're very anxious and, worried. Constant state of worry. This cancer's been really aggressive and has kept coming back, without treatment. Whenever there's a period of no treatment, it aggressively grows. So it's very troubling. And, the whole thing that's scary is if this vaccine isn't working, it's giving the cancer a chance to grow and spread, and which is what happened on one clinical trial of these two drugs she was taking that had absolutely no effect on it. And so, having had that experience, and it's very scary to, be essentially like a guinea pig for an unproven treatment. Anyways, we're still hopeful that this is going to be helpful to Chris, that this is going to give her more time, possibly a cure. And we're grateful for the opportunity to be part of this study. But it is very nerve-wracking, very, you know, it's scary. So, you know, despite how sick chemo made her, it definitely was shrinking the tumor, and she wasn't in that kind of pain in her abdomen from the tumor. So, you know, when you're in pain, you don't have a lot of energy and you're not able to do a whole lot. So it's been affecting, you know, our vlogging, our ability, Chris's ability to get stuff posted. You know, we may have to cut back until she feels better. You know, because she's in pain, has to take some pain meds. She needs to rest a lot more. So hopefully this is really going to kick in and start helping her. So that, I don't know, so that we can try to have somewhat of a normal life. It's... Boy, I don't know. There's just no rest. It's constant stress. And I know I say that a lot, but that's the reality of it. That's our lives. And we keep trying to find the silver linings and enjoy what time we have. You know, the other thing is pain causes people to be in a bad mood. I mean, it's unpleasant, and it's hard to enjoy those waking moments. The time with the family, like, it might make you grumpy or irritable or snappy, but, and you know, sometimes it happens to Chris and we don't take it personally, but you know, it's just, it's tough, man. I don't wish this on anybody. Not even, no one deserves to have to go through this. Talk to you later.
Ava looks so cute today. She has her pixie girl pants on. And this really cute onesie my friend Angie gave her. You look so cute today. Yes, you do. You might not feel cute, but you sure look cute. So, Alyssa just left for a job interview. And Ava has realized she can kiss a lot of different things besides just her dollies. So she's been kissing us and kissing, she just was kissing the chair, I think. So it's really cute. It's like her new thing. She's like, I can kiss anything I want to kiss, not just dollies. So cute. Okay.
Hey there. Some summer, it says 61 degrees and raining. Not at all what I'm used to. Anyways, of course, rain's making the traffic heavy. And Chris is alone with Ava because Alyssa had to leave early, and I'm not going to get home anytime soon to help, so I'm frustrated about that. Whatever. So work was pretty busy trying to get ahead because I need to take the day off tomorrow. I guess it's going to be a frustrating commute home. You probably don't want to watch this. It can get ugly. Okay. Well, I will talk to you guys later. Bye.
I was dancing to Enrique. She's dancing with her dad.
No, I was...
Oh, yeah, you should pick her up and dance with her, honey. Won't daddy pick you up and dance with you? Dancey dance. Aw, are you dancing with daddy?
Yay, Ava.
I can't see you guys though. Pick her up and hold her and show her Enrique. You want to see Enrique? You like it, Ava?
She looks like she likes it.
Ava, that's Enrique Iglesias. You gonna have a crush on him?
Is that your first crush, Ava?
Hey, thanks for sharing my day.
Thanks.
Here you go. Ava has a purse now. Here, put it on your arm. Oh, wow, look at you. Wow. That's a nice purse for the baby girl.